Yeah, I'll be talking to you on tips and tricks in diabetic vitrectomy, slight change of gears. So this is a surgery being done. You can see that I'm using the 10,000 bevel cutter. So the bevel cutter is very good. I'm using the reflex, that is the hydro dissection that we do. So this is the hydro dissection that we do. So we inject by just pushing fluid underneath the membrane, and that clears this membrane off the retinal surface, and then you can clear it off with the probe. Now, because the tip of the probe is closer to the opening is closer to the tip, you can actually do it very well. Now, a lot of times you come across situations wherein you cannot find the dissection plane. So I use a 26 gauge 1.5 inch needle, which is slightly bent at its tip, and that gives me the dissection plane to dissect these membranes. So you can find out their number of membranes. So once I get that plane of cleavage, I know now that I can dissect this membrane clear of the retina. So this is a very critical phase. Unless you are in the cleavage plane, you will not be able to dissect these membranes and cause a lot of iatrogenic trauma. So this is one good way of identifying that. Now, there are a lot of situations when you have a broad adhesion. In broad adhesion, mind you, the best is to use a bimanual. So whenever you have a broad adhesion, here the broad adhesion is at the macula. So I know that if I start doing it only with the probe, it will damage the macula. So I use the bimanual dissection to help me out. So you can see that all the blood vessels are also spared. I'm actually sparing the blood vessel there. This is the arcade blood vessel. So the bimanual surgery is extremely useful in this situation. So you can dissect it. So as I come towards the macula, I can dissect it without causing trauma to the retina. So this is one good way of doing it in broad adhesions. Now, another way is to how to identify the cleavage plane. This is another video. You would see that I'm trying to dissect this, but just now you can see that that is the plane of cleavage. You get another membrane. So remember that diabetes has multiple layers of membranes. So unless you are in the correct cleavage plane, you will not be able to dissect it. So I'm able to now go underneath that membrane. I'm just doing blunt dissection. I'm not doing anything. I'm not using anything else. It just separates out. I will show you in the latter part of the video. See, after you identify the cleavage plane, actually with just the forceps, you can take it out. So just to show you how easy, if you are in the plane, you can do this. Only if you are in the plane. Then you can use the probe to dissect this membrane completely. Just to show you how, without much of, it just dissects out. So you would see that these are tough membranes, but it dissects out very nicely. There's a lot of fluid underneath the retina, but even then, the retina behaves very well. So you can clear it off fully. So now there are a lot of situations. This is a patient whom we had vitreous hemorrhage, and I did vitrectomy. At the end of surgery, it looked like this. Now, I know most of you will say, that's fine, everything looks good. But I stained it with triamcinolone, and you see this vitreous phase is still present there. Actually, vitreoschisis is very common in diabetics. So remember that you need to stain it with triamcinolone to identify this chitic membrane, and only then you'll be able to complete your vitrectomy. So you can see that the entire vitreous is present at the back. What looked very clear is not completely taken off. So you find that patients come with recurrent vitreous hemorrhage because you have the scaffold still present, so proliferation occurs and they bleed. And you come back and say, I've done a vitrectomy, but nothing seems to work. That is because of this reason. So remember that you need to stain and try to remove all these before you say that your surgery is complete. Now the surgery is complete. So in conclusion, the status of PVD will decide on how you approach it. Identify the cleavage plane. Actually, the whole step is to find out where is the cleavage plane. Dissection can be done with probe alone. I use the hydro dissection and the bimanual in difficult situations. Sometimes I do use pre-op anti-VEGF. In eye study, I found that I did it in about 20% of our cases. I've used anti-VEGF. All the rest I've done without anti-VEGF. Thank you. You have any questions? I think I have 1 minute time, so if you can.
Sometimes it's very difficult to take out the second membrane beyond the equator. You can easily take out from till the equator, it's very easy to take out the second membrane after using the triamcinolone neuron. But after equator, because the retina in combined RD, diabetic combined RD.
In combined RD, then yes. You would have to use some PFCL to help you stabilize it. Yes. Because otherwise you will not be able to do it. Yes. Otherwise, what one should do is use bimanual to do a blunt dissection of the, because in the periphery it's easier to do bimanual. By unimanual, it tends to be tougher.
Okay, thank you.
If we have holes in that iatrogenic, then which tamponade do you prefer?
If there are iatrogenic holes that occur during your surgery, I use a silicone oil if I feel that there's a lot of fluid still and I would need to do more laser. Then I use silicone oil because I do post-op laser for those patients after the retina attaches. If I feel the retina is reasonably good and I'm able to flatten the retina nicely and do good laser, then I'll use gas.
And so sometimes some stumps are there. We know, like, if we cut this and we'll directly go through retina, there will be a iatrogenic hole. Is it wise to leave it?
I remove all the membranes. If you leave a scaffold, they bleed again. Remember that all these are scaffolds and they bleed. So the reason why recurrent vitreous hemorrhage is common after diabetic vitrectomy is because of these scaffolds that are present. So I clear off everything, actually.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, always remember the culprit in the diabetic vitrectomy is not the vitreous hemorrhage, it is the vitreous which is providing the scaffold for the new blood vessels from the retina into the surface. So you have to remove all the membranes. So